Professor Dave here. Let's learn about higher derivatives.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We've learned how to take the derivative of a variety of functions, and we know that the derivative of a function is itself a function. But if the derivative is a function, what is to stop us from taking the derivative of the derivative? Well, nothing, in fact. We can do this, and we call it the second derivative, with respect to the original function. So if we have some function f, and we take the derivative, we get f prime. And if we try to get f prime prime, or f double prime, which is the derivative of the derivative of f, we must call this the second derivative of f. In Leibniz notation, if we take the derivative of some function y equals f of x, that would be dy over dx. So if we take the derivative of that by placing d over dx out here, that can be represented as d squared y over dx squared. So this notation also indicates a second derivative, just like f double prime. For simple polynomials, finding the second derivative is not hard to do at all. Take 3x squared plus 4x minus 5. Taking the derivative of this by using the power rule, we get 6x plus 4 as the first derivative, and then we just take the derivative of this to get 6 as the second derivative. All we did was take the derivative twice. Of course, this could get a little trickier. Take x sine x. To get the first derivative, we need the product rule. So remembering how that works from a previous tutorial, let's put the functions where they go and take these two derivatives. We should get x cosine x plus sine x. Then, to get the second derivative, we just take the derivative of this new function. For the first term, again we need the product rule. So we set it up just as we are used to and evaluate the derivatives. That should give us negative x sine x plus cosine x. And then we can't forget this other term here, which simply becomes cosine x. So that gives us negative x sine x plus 2 cosine x as our answer. So why is this useful? Well, let's recall that a derivative represents the rate of change of a function. This means that a second derivative represents the rate of change of the rate of change of the function. That may sound confusing, but there is an extremely good use for this in kinematics, the study of motion, which we covered in the classical physics course. We can make a graph of the position of an object versus time. This could be a falling object, a speeding car, pretty much anything. As we've mentioned before, the derivative of this position function will be the rate of change in the function, or the change in position with respect to time. And that's velocity. So velocity is the derivative of position. But the derivative of this velocity function will be the change in velocity with respect to time, and that's acceleration. Position is meters, velocity is meters per second, and acceleration is meters per second, or meters per second squared. That means that acceleration is the second derivative of position, and that a of t equals v prime of t equals s double prime of t. This is one way of understanding the acceleration due to gravity on Earth as it relates to Galileo's law for the position of an object in freefall. He derived the equation 4.9 t squared by observation, and if we take the derivative of this, we get 9.8 t. And if we take the derivative of that, we get 9.8. And this is why acceleration due to gravity on Earth is a constant equal to 9.8 meters per second squared. This understanding makes it extremely simple to answer questions in physics that would be tedious without calculus. For example, say we have this function, s of t, that represents the position of an object, t cubed minus 5t squared plus 8t minus 1. What will be the acceleration of the object after 5 seconds? Without calculus, this would be very cumbersome to solve. But it's easy for us now because we just find the second derivative and plug in the number 5. The first derivative, v of t, will be 3t squared minus 10t plus 8. Then the second derivative, a of t, must be 6t minus 10. Since this represents the acceleration at any time t, then to find the acceleration at precisely 5 seconds, we just plug in 5. A of 5 will be 6 times 5, or 30, minus 10, which is 20 meters per second squared. Now, although we won't go beyond the second derivative all that often, there is nothing stopping us from taking a third derivative, or a fourth, or as many as we like. The third derivative will simply be the derivative of the second derivative, which we can write as f triple prime, or as d cubed y over dx cubed. For the fourth derivative, it's getting to be too many primes, so we just write f and then the number 4 in parentheses as a superscript. From there, taking the nth derivative will look like this, with the n up here, and we can get it by differentiating a function n times. So that's all there is to higher derivatives. These will return later when we go back to graphing functions, but for now, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.